Let us continue with our lesson, and today we'll be learning about the Kotlin in our class. And on the previous lesson, we have learned about the Kotlin nested class. So let's get started and let us jump into our Android Studio project over here. And I'll be using a same class, which is of television. And if you don't have this project, just go back and watch my previous videos and complete all of the lesson. And we'll be using a same project as our previous lesson, so make sure you have this class. And let's get started now. So on a previous lesson, when we have a nested class over here, when we created a nested class, and the problem over here was that this tag, we wanted to get access to the property of our outer class. We have a tag over here, which is a private variable from our outer class of television. We wanted to access that private variable inside our television USB port class, which is of a nested class, but we don't have access. So that's the problem over here. So how we can solve this problem is that by creating an inner class. So let's go and create an inner class. I'll just copy this one and let's go and just paste it over here. And instead of a USB, I will call it as a HDMI. And let's create over here as a HDMI1 and also this one to HDMI2. And this one let's change to HDMI, right? And this one also to HDMI. Not the nested, it should be inner class. So I'm a HDMI inner class. Now, if you want to get access to this variable, which is the property from our outer class, we can make this class as an inner. To make this class as an inner, we can just make use of a keyword of an inner, and inner class television HDMI port. Now, whenever we make this class as an inner class, you can see that this tag has access. Now, we have access to this outer class a tag variable that we have created in outer class. So this property now can be accessed from our inner class. So that's the very simple way that how we create an inner class in Kotlin using a keyword of inner. So whenever we want to make a class, the nested class, to convert to an inner class, we can just make use of an inner keyword, and that class will be converted as an inner class. So whenever we make a class as an inner class, we will have access to the outer class properties. And let's say that, let's give a tag over here of our remote, or we can just say as this is of nested. And let's go back to our activity and let's create a valve. TV1 is equals to television, television dot, we have access to television HDMI port class, which is inner class. And why this is giving error over here is constructor of inner class can be called only with the receiving of a containing class. So there is an error. So how to solve this error is, what does it actually mean? Is the constructor of inner class television HDMI port can only be called with receiving of a containing class. So what we can do is we can just put the constructor over here and dot the television HDMI port. So there is a little bit difference on creating an object or accessing the inner class than the nested class. So here we don't have to mention, or we don't have to call a constructor over here, and we can just directly access the nested class, which is like just accessing any of the static property, right? So whenever we want to access the static variable or any of the method, we can directly make use of the class without constructing it and directly call it. But here, this is not a static. This is not a static class. That's why we have to make use of a constructor. We have to create a constructor, and then we can call the inner class. So accessing or the creating object of an inner class is a little bit different than a nested class. So if you have already seen it over here, so just a basic difference. So make sure you understand it properly. And now we can have access to TV1 dot. We have access to HTML, and if you try to run it, just run it, and you should have access. And let's just go and create the tag of a remote. Let's copy this one and let's go to the log cat over here. Let's filter it out. And now I am a HTML inner class. So that's all for this lesson, and hope you guys understand that how to create an object from a nested inner class and how do we access the inner class properties as well as the methods. So we'll continue with our lesson on our next video. Till then, have a great day.